9 power plays propelled the Huskies to a 5-2 win. Helen, welcome inside the studio for your post-game report. I'm your host, Joe Scarella. We're going to take a look back at how this game unfolded and how the Huskies got it done, starting things off in the first period. Coach Motzko trying to keep his boys on the winning way as they welcome the all-time winningest coach in college hockey history, Jerry York, leading the Eagles into the Brooks Center for the very first time. The Eagles on the first real chance of the night, Brown splits the middle. He would get hooked up on the play and send the Huskies to the penalty kill. On that power play chance, the Eagles moving the puck north and south. Fitzgerald finds the blade of Logan Hutzko, and he redirects it home. It passed Jeff Smith, only the second goal the Huskies have allowed shorthanded this season. They trail 1-0. Minutes later, the Eagles looking to extend it on the odd man rush, but Jimmy Schultz, the NCHC's top player 2 weeks in a row, able to break that up. Huskies on the power play of their own, trying to pull even. Benson and Peterson clawing away and looking for an opportunity of their own, but unable to sneak one past. Early in the second period, a scary hit on Jack Poehling as he picked up the puck and took a hit to the head. That sends the Huskies on the power play for their second time. Poehling a little shaken up on the play. The penalty kill for the Eagles was fantastic. And so is the transition game up the ice. Brown going hard to the net. Nothing Smith can do on the second chance. And they're able to put one home for the second goal. The Maroon and Gold. Maroon and Gold lead by 2. Sometimes you just need a bounce to go your way. The Huskies would get that. The puck lying on the doorstep. The entire team battling for it. And it's Kevin Fitzgerald finally able to get it to go. Huskies pull within a goal. Don't say there's no such thing as momentum. The very next shift, Judd Peterson cuts the top of the circle and fires one at the net. The rebound comes to Jack Poehling, and that hard hit he took early in the period, but he's able to tie the game, and that sends us into the third period. Coach Jerry York looking for win number 1014, but his team would be put on the penalty kill for too many men on the ice. The Huskies getting the puck out on the point. Jack Eshon looking for his target. He would find it, the first power play goal of the night for the Huskies. Later in the period, the Cardinal and Black looking to extend their lead. Mikey Asimont with a filthy move and a beautiful dish. It ends up finding Robbie Jackson back out at the point, and Robbie puts it home. He makes it a 2-goal margin. They would review it for goaltender interference, but it's ruled Enquist was hit by his own defender, and that's how this one would go final. St. Cloud State getting the victory 5-2. Let's take a look at some of the stats from tonight's game. Huskies dominates on the shots on goal category, 47-20. Block shots, we talked about it in the open and the entire game. Boston College able to get 10, but it wasn't enough to keep the Huskies off the board. Penalties in favor of the Huskies as they only went to the box 4 times. Boston College able to capitalize on one of those opportunities. The penalties on the other side, Boston College, way too many. 10 penalties, and they were St. Cloud State was 2-for-9 on the power play. Faceoffs, the Huskies dominant in that category as well, 44-21. What does Motzko have to say about the win?
A great skating team and great puck moving team, and that's like really early too in the game why we were trying to adjust. I mean, they were, you know, spreading it out tic-tac-toe, and you know, we were chasing the puck a lot in the first period. Well, we got to quit falling back all the time. I mean, you know, we can score goals, so that's the good thing, but it's going to bite us one of these times. You know, you can't keep doing it. We work hard, man. I mean, our guys compete. That's been a backbone of ours since last spring. Robbie's scoring goals now. You know, he's feeling good. He's got a big-time shot, and it's great. We needed guys. I kept talking all year. We got 8 guys that are returning that need to take steps, and we're starting to see it with Robbie. That's such a huge advantage when our building lights on fire like that, and then when you tie it, our guys just kept feeding, the crowd kept going, and it was a good home intense crowd tonight for our guys to feed off of. What I said, you were nervous early in the game, so like we had, there's 2 or 3 times where we had puck right on tape and we drop it. But now when you're feeling good about your game, you're catching passes, your senses are on, we're making good passing plays. We got a little net front presence finally going, which we had to do. We got some pucks through their traffic, onto their goalies. So and power plays have to learn to win games. And, you know, and there was a lot of penalties. That's uncharacteristic of both these teams. So we'll have to, you know, adjust to that tomorrow.
St. Cloud State able to get the victory 5-2. Boston College comes in tomorrow night looking for the split, as the next broadcast will be tomorrow night on Fox Sports North. Turn out the lights, the party's over, the Huskies get the win. We'll see you next time here on Husky Productions.